two corporate giants are battling it out over what amounts to about $1 a month per cable subscriber. Why are Time Warner and CBS fighting? The CEO of CBS, Les Moonves, describes it as a war over so-called carriage fees. That's the amount a cable operator pays for the right to transmit a particular channel. CBS is asking for an increase from Time Warner from $1 per subscriber to $2. And for that, Time Warner customers in New York and LA, throughout negotiations this summer, have been losing access to the country's most popular television network. Time Warner's position? It's not fair to make cable customers pay for programming that others are receiving for free. Others being people with simple antennas. Those still exist. Time Warner contends it's being squeezed and can't be giving in each time a channel asks for more money. To make its point, the company offers this infographic showing how if every channel demanded another 2 cents per day, it would add $48 per month to subscribers' bills.
Metal fingers beckoning to the invisible.
These aren't the good old days when networks were sustained by advertising dollars alone. So will prices for cables just keep going up? Cable operators have been seeing their fees for carrying channels rise 37% since 2008. Customers will decide to say, forget cable. They'll just watch their favorite shows over the internet and maybe get an antenna to use for watching live broadcasts. For the broadcasters who love those fees they're getting, one challenge in particular comes from Aereo, which for $8 a month rents subscribers a little antenna in its server farm and streams network TV content to them. All this helps explain why some are speculating that the future of cable might not include TV. Cablevision CEO telling the Wall Street Journal he predicts transmission of TV will move to the internet eventually, effectively cutting out the cable operators, who then have to make all their money by offering the high-speed delivery pipe. So what's at stake in this battle? Perhaps in the long run, the existing cable business model. That's the short answer.